Hi, Satnam. So we're getting closer to Friday, which I teach Friday at a Raj Yoga studio. I teach my Divine Feminine Circle. It's a woman's circle, and I just invite you to come. And if you're not close to Sterling, Virginia, I invite you to join my Saturday online class, which is kind of like my circle here, Raj Yoga, but it's just a little, it's online, so it's a little different. But I invite you, it's based on donations. But anyways, so you know, this whole concept of us feminine, you know, we are very like the moon. You know, the moon goes through its different cycles. And just like the moon goes through different cycles, the woman is very made like that. Something that Jogi Bhajan said is the calendars were not made for men, calendars were made for women, because women need that calendar in order for her to know her cycle, in order for her to know where she's at. And not just her cycle, her lunar cycle, but also, you know, the different phases that she's in her life. You know, as women, we go through, which is called, like, it's kind of like the seasons, you know, our younger days when we're younger, it's considered our springtime. And, you know, and as we become in our 20s and our 30s, it's considered our spring, summer. And then as we become older, in our 40s, 50s, and even 60s, I would say that it's considered us to be in a fall, and that's our golden time, our prime. And then we get to be in the winter, when it's the wisdom, you know, it's the sacredness of the woman. And something that Jogi Bhajan said is that woman doesn't even become her true self until she's in her 70s, that's when she truly starts living. And I really see it in a lot of women that are getting to be in their 70s or in their late 60s, you know, early 70s. I really see that that is their prime. That is where they know themselves. That's what they feel comfortable in their body, you know, and sensuality and sexuality, you know, it's part of the whole feminine. And us owning our body and knowing our bodies, you know, we could still have that divine secret energy and that partnership at any age. And I think this is why it's important that we know our cycles and know where we're at. And there's this video online that really shows the woman and when she's going through the different emotions, you know, from the first days of her psych, of her, the first days of her cycles, and then the middle days of her cycles, and when she's fertile and all that. So you knowing how you go through those emotions and how you're feeling through those emotions, I think makes life very easy, because then you can navigate, and also your moon center, knowing your moon center, you can really navigate and see how you're feeling, where you're at, and the type of foods you can eat. There's this whole thing about the foods that you can eat in certain times of the month when you're feeling a certain way. Again, calendars are made for women, because as women, we're so different. I mean, we're constantly changing. Something that Hari Kaur said one time in the class was that, you know, the pharmaceutical companies don't do testing on women because women are so different. They're always changing. And that's something that they only test on men, because men are always the same. And you know, men are ruled by the sun. It's always constantly the same. And as women, you know, are constantly changing. So as knowing ourselves, knowing and really getting profound to our bodies and our emotional body, like how do we feel? What triggers us, what bothers us, why it bothers us, getting deep down to that core of really truly knowing ourselves. So we have this whole concept of divine energies that we can call upon, all these different archetypes that we have. You know, we have this moon center. I mean, it's a constant thing about growing and knowing ourselves and who we are. But you know, it goes back to that, the divine goddess, the divine mother, the aspect of that we all have inside of us. So when we can just truly come back to that aspect, everything else just becomes, it's like we go beyond those emotions. We go beyond the body, beyond the emotional body. So this is why I think it's so important that we start to know ourselves. I mean, we can take those baby steps of knowing who we are by allowing ourselves to know our bodies, to know our emotional bodies, and to know ourselves and know our cycles again. Know your cycle, know where you're at in your cycle, and know your moon center and get to know your body, get to know who you are as a woman, because then you can be a better presence in the world because you know where you're at. So it's beautiful to know that. So, and then, you know, those different cycles that the woman goes through and those different ages, I think that's phenomenal. You can look it up, you know, the different cycles of a woman through the ages. In each cycle, it's different, it's beautiful, and it's a whole new world that you can explore when you truly start paying attention to who you are as a woman, paying attention to knowing that you are sacred, that, you know, you are completely made different. You know, back in the days, back in the days, you know, the woman was the sacredness, she was worship, she was the mother, you know, before the patriarchy came and took that away. And that divine feminine is waking up, and is waking up between all these women. We're starting to remember our sacredness. Our bodies are craving the gatherings, our bodies are craving us being together in the sacredness and exploring who we truly are. And that's just so divine. So I truly just invite you to take the time to get to know yourself. And, you know, if you love yourself truly, if you're in a space of loving yourself completely and knowing who you are and remembering that you and every single part of your being is divine, and that you are made in the likeness of the God and the Goddess, and that is just so beautiful. And we are created so beautifully, you know, that our womb creates, in our womb births something beautiful, and we still have that creative energy to birth anything we desire. Yogi Bhajan said that we're 16 times more powerful than men. Sorry, men, but that's what Yogi Bhajan said. That we're 16 times more powerful, so we can be 16 times more destructive or 16 times more powerful. So using our mind and really watching our thought form, watching our patterns of how we're thinking and how we're talking to ourselves. Because if we're being negative to ourselves, we're not practicing sacredness. And I think it's very important that we take the vows today, right now, that we're going to be a healing presence in the world, and that we're going to be healing presence to ourselves. Because if we cannot heal ourselves, we definitely cannot teach our children and teach everyone else to be a healing presence. So take the vow right now. Say, I take the vow to treat myself like the goddess that I am, like the divine being that I am. And, you know, when something's not vibrating at that high level of consciousness of what the divine is, know it. Catch yourself. Be in that space of not allowing anything but divineness enter your aura, enter your field, enter your mind. Because when you can be in a state of always vibrating the divine, always vibrating that Nam, you know, that sacred word of God, you are in the healing presence of what you're here to do, you know. And that's why it's so important that you know yourself, that you know your cycles, that you know where you're at, so you can be gentle with yourself when you're going through a bump, and going beyond our emotions. Something that Yogi Bhajan said is that, you know, we don't go anywhere beyond our emotions. Like, we stay here, like, we dress according to how we feel, we act according to how we feel, we treat other people according to how we feel. But when we can go beyond our emotions and see our feelings being more sacred, the emotions are what the body remembers from traumas. If we can go beyond that emotional traumatic body and go towards the higherness of who we are, then we can come back to remembering that we are sacred, that there's this power in our presence, that there's this power in who we are as divine women. And men too, they have this quality. They have the quality of the divine feminine in them. But this message is mostly for women, because we do have our menstrual cycle. We do bleed, you know, and for those women that are not bleeding, you know, even though you don't have your menstrual cycle anymore, you're still going through the process of those changings, and you're still going, because even though you're not doing it anymore, your body still remembers that sacredness. So, you know, it's such another video about the whole menstrual thing. You know, not a lot of people like to talk about it. It's kind of taboo, it's kind of weird, let's not talk about it. But You know, it's beautiful. It's a part of us. We birthed something beautiful and we are constantly birthing ourselves. So I leave you with this little message. Get to know yourself. And if you are in Sterling, Virginia, come to my class. Sat Nam.